Vanishing gradient is a common problem encountered during neural network training. In this video, we'll look into how this problem affects regular artificial neural network and RNN. Here I have a simple neural network that tries to predict if a person will buy insurance or not based on factors such as age, education, income, and so on. When you think about hidden layers, these hidden layers are extracting some features. For example, age and education might affect awareness, income and saving might affect the affordability. When you train this neural network, let's say on a sample data where the age is 29, the income is 150k and so on, during training we will have a forward pass in which these values will be passed, and initially we'll initialize these weights w1 to w10 with some random values or maybe with zero values. And then in the end, we compare the actual output with predicted output and we compute the loss. Then we do backward propagation to update these weights. In backward propagation, for example, to update W9, we will subtract a small factor from W9, which will be learning rate. Learning rate is like small number 0.001002, whatever. And the gradient. The gradient is the most important part. What gradient tells you here is it's represented as a derivative of loss compared to W9, which means how much loss is changing for a given change in W9. So this is a guessing work. You're trying to optimize your loss or minimize your loss, and you want to see how much W9 is changed so that that results into certain amount of change in loss so that you can reduce that loss. So you can think of this as how much awareness contributes to a final output. Let's say awareness contributes 20% to the final output. Affordability contributes 80% to the final output. Then you know this W9, this change, this gradient will be less here. Okay. And now when we think about W1, you want to update W9, W10, all the weights. So when you further back propagate, the equation here will be, the gradient equation would be derivative of loss with respect to W1. And that will be basically, you know, if you have seen my chain rule tutorial, it will be your derivative of loss compared to awareness and derivative of awareness compared to W1, which means how much awareness changes for a given change in W1. So you can see that as you increase number of layers in the neural network, these multiplications will increase. So here for our case, you know, we had like a multiplication of two factors, like, you know, derivative one and derivative two. And if these numbers happen to be small, let's say both D1 and D2 are smaller, then the resulting gradient will be even more smaller. It is a simple math. If you multiply a couple of small numbers, you get even a bigger small number. Not a bigger small number, a smaller small number maybe. So now what happens is when you have a very low gradient, like a very small gradient, your learning process becomes slow. So the equation for W1 new will be W1 old minus learning rate into gradient. Learning rate is, let's say, 0.001. Then 0.001 into 0.0015 is very, very small number. So your W1 is hardly changing. So during your training process, now your weights, especially the weights in the earlier layers, are changing by a very small amount. And that affects your learning process. And this concept is called vanishing gradients. When you have a big neural network, in the earlier network, the gradient effect will be very small. That's why it's called vanishing gradient. It's not good for the neural network training because your weights are hardly changing and you're not really learning anything. You know, it's like a dumb student in the class whom you're teaching so many things and he's hardly learning anything. On the other hand, if the D1 and D2, the values of individual derivatives, are bigger, then the resulting number will be even more bigger. So again, a simple math, when you have a product of multiple numbers and individual numbers, either all of them or some of them are big, your overall product will be very big. And this is called exploding gradients. Now, when you think about deep neural network, you know, which has n number of layers, your gradient becomes even more smaller. So vanishing gradient problem is more prominent in deep neural network. Now let's talk about vanishing gradient problem in RNN. So there is exploding gradient problem also, but vanishing gradient problem is something that affects more. So let's say you have these two statements. So here I am doing an autocomplete NLP task. You know, in Google, when you in Gmail, when you type some line, it tries to autocomplete. Let's say my statement is today, due to my current job situation and family condition, when I type I, or when I say condition comma, my Google, let's say Gmail, tries to autocomplete. I need to take a loan, whatever. Okay. So these are the two statements. Now watch the words which are highlighted in yellow. Here, if I want to use need or had, depends on my first few words in the statement. Because see, all these words, due to my current job situation, they are all same. So you can see that in English language, often the wording that we put in the end, they have, you know, the wording which are in the beginning, they have an impact to the words in the end. You decide the end words based on very initial few words. So if you're training an RNN like this, and if you don't know how this works, I highly recommend you watch my what is RNN video in this same series, because that watching that video is very important. Otherwise you'll be confused, because this is an unrolling of layers, neural network layers, in time. So it's not like we have six layers of neural network. There is just one layer, but this is a timestamp t1, t2, t3. So this we have unrolled into time. For that reason, you want to understand this convention. And for that, you watch my video of what is RNN. So here I'm saying today, due to whatever, my whole sentence, you know, I have dot 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 here. And then my neural network tries to predict, I need to take a loan. So the word need, this is derived based on this first word, today. If I had last month, then I would put I had. So you can see that in RNN, since we are feeding these words in a statement one by one, the vanishing gradient problem becomes more prominent, because you know all these activations that you are passing. So you're passing activation A1, A2, A3. So by the time you are at A4, already the effect of A1 is kind of reduced. And if your English statement is very long, by the time you reach here, the effect of today has significantly reduced, and you will have a hard time predicting this need word. So traditional RNNs are said to have a very short memory. So maybe when you have today, maybe on due or two, maybe till here, there is an impact of today. But as you pass through more words, the impact of the earlier words reduces. And that's why we say it has a short memory. And this shows the impact of vanishing gradients, because as you backpropagate, right, as you backpropagate, what will happen is the vanishing gradient problem will arise here, as you know, these earlier layers will hardly change their weight based on the need. Let's say you are feeding this exact same statement, and here I am finding need, okay, and my actual output was something else, so there was a bigger error. Now that bigger error, when I backpropagate, by the time it comes here, it will have resulted into vanishing gradients. And we have two solutions for it, which is GRU and LSTM, and these are like special types of RNNs or neural networks which addresses the problem of short-term memory. So we'll look into this in the future videos. I hope you like this particular video. If you do, please give it a thumbs up and watch my complete deep learning tutorial series. I have a complete machine learning tutorial series as well as deep learning tutorial series with theory, exercise, code, and everything. So please check it out. Thank you.